Investor reacts to Dave Ramsey. What stocks should I buy as a beginner? Yes, we are talking about Dave Ramsey, not Gordon Ramsey. So there are several statements in his video that I, as an investor, don't agree with. Really, you really don't have to say this. Like, no, 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 no. So this is the video I am talking about. But first of all, let's intro. D&D Finance, helping you making better financial decisions. Subscribe to this channel, hit the notification bell so that you don't miss any upcoming videos. So let's get started. So it is on his YouTube channel, and his YouTube channel has almost 2 million subscribers. So he's very established and popular. So this is in his radio show, and an audience, someone asked him during this radio this question: what stocks should I buy as a beginner? So let's start with the first statement that I disagree with Gordon Ramsay.
What is a good starter stock to invest in, and how much should I invest?
Okay, I don't invest in single stocks. They're too much risk.
So this is the first statement that I disagree with Gordon Ramsay, that picking a single stock is too much risk, which is not true at all. So here you can see also a news article from MarketWatch. So it is a specialized magazine only about the stock market. And they also say that stocks are not that risky. Actually, stocks are not risky at all. It all depends on you, whether you know which stocks you should pick. So it's more about the knowledge you have than about the stocks itself. Because if you don't know which stocks to pick, you will lose money. It's similar to, for example, like riding a bicycle. If you don't know how to ride a bicycle, you will fall off the bicycle right away. So it's not that the bicycle is risky, it's just you don't know how to ride a bicycle. Smash the like button. That's the same thing like with picking stocks. Yeah, I mean, Dave Ramsey is, as you can see here, is an American radio host. And he's also an author of a book and a businessman. But he's not a professional investor. He never worked in a bank before. And he also never worked in Wall Street before. So that's why he doesn't know that much about the stock market. And that's why he can be very wrong when it comes to stocks in the stock market. All right, next one. Let me see. Oh yeah, this one. This is another statement of him that I disagree with. Any questions so far? Feedbacks or comments? Just leave it in the video description below.
If you spread your money across several things instead of putting it in one thing, that's called diversification, and it gives you safety. Do you?
So this is another statement of him that I also disagree with. So he says that he doesn't buy a single stock, but he buys like a basket of stocks, like several, many, many stocks. And that's why it is, that's what it is about. Diversification. So it's about diversification, he said. And he said that diversification generates safety. So it's safer to buy many types of stocks than picking a single stock. That's something that I also disagree with him. What is your favorite stock? Comment in the video description below. I might want to make a video about it. Because Warren Buffett, and he is one of the, well, he is one of the best investor in the world, and he's also one of the richest person in the world. And he said, his quote, "Diversification is a protection against ignorance," Buffett once said. "It makes very little sense for those who know what they're doing." So this is what I also mentioned before. It's more about your knowledge. You have to know what you're doing. So diversification, it doesn't generate any safety. If you buy 10 different stocks from 10 different bad companies, you will have bad results. If you buy good stocks, you will have good results. It's more about your knowledge. You have to know what kind of stocks you buy. All right, here comes the next statement that I disagree with Dave Ramsey.
Do you see what I'm talking about?
Yes.
Yeah, so I invest in good growth stock mutual funds. Now, it's in stocks.
So, yeah, he said he invests in mutual funds. So, mutual funds are like a basket of many, many companies. So there are mutual funds out there which invest into like 100s of companies. So that's what he was talking about, diversification. And yeah, for a beginner who don't know which stocks to buy, it is indeed a good idea to start with a fund, not necessarily mutual funds. But Warren Buffett also mentions that he would buy an index fund instead for the average investor. He also said in that most people shouldn't pick a single stock. So for the average investor, it is, according to Warren Buffett, and he's the best, or one of the best, well, he's the best investor in the world, and he's also the richest, one of the richest person in the world. So yeah, for the average investor, it is a good idea to buy an index fund, according to Warren Buffett. But in general, whether it's mutual funds or index funds, that doesn't matter, any kind of funds. All right, here comes the next statement that I disagree with Dave Ramsey.
Type of thing I invest in. I don't own any single stocks. I don't go buy such and such.
Yeah, I mean, just because he doesn't buy any single stock doesn't mean that everyone shouldn't buy any single stock. So as it is just for the beginners that they shouldn't buy a single stock. But if you like dig deeper into the stock market, if you put more effort and time into the stock market, then it is better to buy a single stock. But as a beginner, or for someone who doesn't want to put much effort to learn more about the stock market, it is a good idea to buy funds. Also, yeah, I mean, as a bit for like a side hustle, is a good idea to generate money in the stock market on the side. All right. The next one that I disagree with Dave Ramsey. Let's do this.
A company and then try to figure out by Friday if it's a good idea and jump back out of it. I don't fool with all that. The people that I meet that are wealthy, the majority of them are slow and steady.
Yes, it is about long-term investment, slow and steady. That's something that Warren Buffett also mentioned. He said, where is it? Ah, yeah, here it is. Warren Buffett said that his favorite holding period is forever. So he buys stocks and hold it like decades, even, well, forever. I mean, forever is a little bit extreme, but yeah, as long as possible. Subscribe and see you next time.